Welcome to the Novus Visual Protocol series. In this video, we'll learn how to perform all phases of a Western blot using the most common methods for this assay. Before we can start preparing the blot, we must first prepare our sample lysate. In this example, we'll prepare a protein lysate from cultured cells. Here, we wash the cells twice with ice-cold PBS and add enough lysis buffer to cover the cells. The choice of lysis buffer depends largely upon the localization of your protein of interest. We scrape the cells and transfer the cell solution to a centrifuge tube placed on ice. In order to solubilize membrane-bound proteins, we will require stronger extraction detergents compared to isolating cytoplasmic proteins. In this example, we are using a standard RIPA buffer, which is a common buffer for obtaining maximum protein yield while extracting proteins from all cellular localizations. It is very important to include protease inhibitors in your lysis buffer, which will prevent degradation of your sample. Always use freshly prepared protease inhibitors, keep samples on ice, and work quickly. We lyse the cells by pipetting up and down, followed by incubation on ice for 30 minutes. Then, centrifuge the cells into a pellet. Discard the pellet and collect the supernatant. This is your lysate. Determine the total protein concentration of your sample lysate by testing a small portion of the lysate with a commercially available protein quantitation assay, such as the BCA. This will assist you in loading equal amounts of protein into your gel. Western blots are traditionally performed under reduced and denatured conditions. These conditions will allow proteins to be separated by their molecular weight rather than their native conformational shape or charge. To reduce and denature samples, dilute each in a loading buffer, such as the traditional Lamley buffer. This buffer contains beta-mercaptoethanol, or DTT, to reduce disulfide ridges between cysteines, SDS to assist denaturing and provide a net negative charge to the proteins, glycerol to allow the samples to sink into each well, bromophenol blue to visualize the lysate, and an ionic buffer. Vortex each sample and incubate at 95 degrees Celsius for 5 minutes to completely denature the proteins. You are now ready to load your samples into an SDS page gel.